Hello guys, I am Alok Prakash and I am back again with a new video. Today in this video I am going to show you how to fix external display when you have done standalone installation of PrimeOS. So guys, first you have to boot your PrimeOS and then go to settings. And in the settings we have to go to PrimeOS settings. Inside that you will find root access, which we have to enable to apps only, and then open FX Explorer and go to its setting. Inside setting you will find developer root access, enable it, and then click on back, and in the home page you will find system root. Click on that and then go to MNT folder and then create a new folder and give it a name SDA. After creating that folder you have to again go to the system root folder, and inside that you have to go to dev folder, and inside that block folder. When you entered in the block folder, you will notice that there are many files with the name starting with SDA in the bottom of the folder. In my case there are many SDA folder because I have many partitions on my hard drive. So one of these partition is actually unmounted, and I know in my case SDA2 is unmounted, in which android.configuration file is present. So I am going to mount it first inside PrimeOS. So guys, to open command line tools you have to press alt plus F1 and write the code I am writing, but you need to make some changes in the command that I am writing, like in the place of SDA2 you have to write the partition name that you are going to mount. In my case SDA2, in your case it may be SDA1, SDA2 or anything that you are mounting. And MNT SDA is our directory in which we are pointing our mount partition. And when you have done, press enter and then press alt plus F7 to get exit out of command line. After mounting the partition guys, you have to go to the MNT folder inside system root and then go to SDA folder that we have created, and inside this you will find that many files and folders will appear. You have to go inside the EFI folder and then Android folder, and inside it you will find android.cfg file. We have to edit this configuration file. Guys, in my earlier video I already told you that what code we need to write in the configuration file to fix our external monitor screen. So go and watch this video. That video I already put its link in the description. So thank you guys.